In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Our Father, we give you all the praises. Lord, we appreciate you because of the excellency of your power. Thank you, Father, once again for this wonderful day, the day of the Lord, the day of power, the day of resurrection. Thank you once again for the way you have been with us right from the beginning of today. Thank you once again for this moment of prayer, sweet hour of prayer, a time to commune with the Father, with the Son, with the Holy Spirit. I pray, Lord, that in this session of prayer, of God, our strength you will renew tonight in Jesus' name.
Amen.
I pray, Lord, that every one of us connected on this prayer platform, prayer network, all of us all together, we shall experience the move of your Spirit in our lives, in our family, in our ministry, and everything connected to us, O God, will receive transformation. We receive the touch of heaven tonight in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Thank you, our Father in heaven. We appreciate you, Lord. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
I want to open my Bible. Please open your turn your Bible with me. I read from the book of Psalm 100. Psalm 100. Please turn your Bible with me to Psalm 100. And I want to read verse 1. It says, make a joyful noise unto the Lord, all ye lands. Serve the Lord with gladness. Come before his presence with singing. That's why we are coming before God tonight. In verse 4, enter into his gates with thanksgiving, and into his courts with praise. Be thankful unto him and bless his name. For the Lord is good, and his mercy and his truth endureth to all generations. We want to appreciate God tonight. We want to lift up our voices unto him and say, God, thank you because of whom you are. Thank you because of your mercy upon our lives. Thank you for the joy of coming to your presence. In the presence of God that is fullness of joy. In the presence of God that is fullness of power. In the presence of God that is awakening. In the presence of God that is refreshing. In the presence of God that is a reviver. Why don't you open your mouth and give all the glory to God and say, Father, thank you once again, O God. You have started with us all these years. And here we are once again tonight in your presence. Let's give all the glory unto him. Let's appreciate God. Let's lift up our voices in appreciation unto God of heaven. Let's thank him and say, Father, you have been so good. You have been so nice. You have been so wonderful. Please open your mouth. I want to hear us praying tonight, brethren. I want to hear us praying. Open your mouth and let's worship God. Let's give him all the glory. Let's give him all the honor. Let's give him all the adoration. Let's thank you once again because of all his numerous and uncountable blessings.
Thank you.
You are the Almighty God. You are the Omnipotent God. You are the never dying God. You are the unchangeable God, O Lord, everlasting Father. Lord, we thank you tonight, O God, because your power never fails. Thank you once again, O Lord, because, O God, your miracle is just continuous, is everlasting, O God. Thank you once again because of the abundance of your mercy. Your mercy upon every pastor represented on this network. Your mercy upon my life. Your mercy upon our respective family. Your mercy upon our individual family members. Your mercy upon our wives. Your mercy upon the husband. Your mercy upon the children. Your mercy upon the church, your mercy upon everything that we know that is connected to us. Oh, dear Father, we say, God, you are good, you are great, you are mighty. Almighty God, we exalt you. Thank you, Father, once again, O Lord. In Jesus' name, we are praying.
In Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen. The Bible tells us, it says, thanks be to God, who giveth all the victory. Victory over the devil. Victory over Satan. Victory over all the ganging up of the wicked in this country. Victory over all the satanic agents. Victory over the conspirators. Victory over all the forces of darkness. Why don't you open your mouth and join me to praise God tonight and say, Father, thank you for the victory. Our ears are hearing of all the wonderful things you are doing. How you are discomfiting all the Egyptians of our own time. Father, open your mouth and begin to appreciate God. Let's give him all the praises and say, Father, thank you once again, O Lord, we are grateful. Father, we are grateful unto you, God. Please open your mouth and bless the name of the Lord. There is blessing, there is power. When we praise God with all our hearts, when we praise God, not half-hearted praising God. Please praise him with all your hearts. Allow yourself, release yourself to praise him. Release your hands to praise God. Honor God, open your mouth and praise God once again tonight. Let's give him all the glory. In Jesus' name, we pray.
Amen.
We give you all the glory. We give you honor. We give you all the glory. We give you honor, honor. We give you all the glory. We give you honor. We give you all the glory. We give you honor, oh Lord. We give you all the glory, oh, we give you honor. We give you all the glory. We give you honor. We give you all the glory, oh, we give you honor. We give you all the glory. We give you honor, oh Lord. We open your mouth and sing that song.
Father,
all the glory, we give you honor.
We give you all the glory. We give you honor.
Amen. Amen. Brother, we want to pray. We want to begin with ourselves. We are going to pray for Nigeria, but I want to keep that one aside for now. We are going to pray. I want to begin this prayer. Let's open our Bible to Ephesians chapter 3. Please turn your Bible with me to Ephesians chapter 3. We are going to pick the prayer requests from that place, one after the other. Ephesians chapter 3. Ephesians chapter 3, I read from verse 14, all through to verse 21. Ephesians chapter 3, that's where we're going to pick some of the prayer requests from now. Ephesians chapter 3, from verse 14. He said, for this cause, I bow my knees unto the Father of our Lord Jesus. Just as we are united together in prayer, and we are ready to, we bow our heart, we bow our spirit, we bow our knee, we bow our thoughts, we bow everything, our entire personality, before the great God of heaven, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ. He said, of whom the whole family in heaven and earth is named, that he will grant you, that's the prayer request, that he will grant unto you and I, everyone connected on this network tonight, whether by Zoom or maybe through phone, or by conference, network, and all of that means, he said that he will grant you, according to the riches of his glory, to be strengthened with might by his spirit in the inner man. We want to pray for every pastor. We want to pray for every one of our pastors on this platform, and all our brethren, all our brothers, all our sisters, connected, and even those who join us from other churches. We want to pray tonight. We want to tell God, oh great God, Lord, strengthen us once again. with might in our inner man. If your inner man is weak, let me tell you, you will not be able to pray. If your inner man is tired, is weary, you will not be able to be effective in the service of God. We want to pray tonight and say, God, strengthen us with might and power in our inner man. Open your mouth and begin to pray. Open your mouth and lift up your voice and say, God, oh Lord, I bring my inner man before you tonight. I bring my inner man once again unto you, God. Strengthen us once again with might. Strengthen us, oh God, in our inner man. With might, with power, with the Holy Ghost in our inner man tonight. Open your mouth and begin to pray. Let's ask God and say, God, begin to strengthen us. Strength in our spirit man. Strength in our inner man. Strength to be able to be up and doing for the Lord. Strength to be very proactive for the things of God. Open your mouth and begin to pray and call upon the Lord tonight. Oh Lord, we need the strength. The Bible said the Lord is the strength of his anointed. He's the saving strength of his anointed. Open your mouth and pray. And say,
Father,
God, release that supernatural strength into my inner man tonight. Into my inner man. Into our inner man. Oh Lord, strengthen us with might by your spirit, oh God, by the Holy Ghost. In our inner man, every widow, every talent, every golden, let everything vanish out of our life tonight. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, strength is coming to us tonight. Strength is coming upon our life tonight. Strength in our soul, strength in our spirit, strength even to be able to tarry and to pray through. Open your mouth and begin to pray tonight. Let's open our mouth and call upon the Lord and say, God, release that supernatural strength upon our life. Even tonight, in the name of Jesus Christ, open your mouth and begin to pray.
Glory all of
I'm not hearing us pray, brethren. Open your mouth and pray. Let's call upon the Lord. Where two or three are gathered together in my name, there I am in the midst of them. Open your mouth and ask God and say, Lord, strengthen me with might by your spirit in my inner man. Even tonight, mighty God, I'm asking my Father God, oh Lord, strengthen us again with might by the Holy Ghost in our inner man. Let my inner man begin to receive strength, oh God. Let my inner man begin to receive power. Let my inner man begin to receive
Father,
strength. Oh Lord, my Father, the fervency, the vigor in my inner man. Even tonight, in the name of Jesus Christ, Almighty God, I'm asking my Father God, oh Lord, begin to release your supernatural strength even upon our life tonight, oh God, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. In Jesus' name, we are praying.
Amen.
In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
We want to pray once again. We are still praying in that line, but I want to digress a little. We are going to pray. The Bible tells us in chapter 11, verse 1, he said, while Jesus Christ was praying in a certain place, when he ceased, one of his disciples said unto him, Lord, teach us to pray. Tonight, we want to call upon the Lord. Oh, Lord, teach us to pray. He said, likewise, the Spirit helpeth our infirmities, for we know not what we should pray as we ought to. But the Spirit helpeth our infirmity to pray. We want to pray and say, God, tonight, let the Holy Ghost begin to intercede even through us tonight. Open your mouth and begin to pray and tell the Lord. Oh, Lord, teach us to pray. Oh, Lord, teach us to pray. The Spirit of prayer and supplication, let it come upon every one of us. And it shall come to pass in that day. Today is the day. Today is the day. And it shall come to pass in that day that I will pour upon the house of David and upon the inhabitants of Jerusalem the spirit of grace and of supplication. Are you praying for that prayer? Are you praying for that grace? Spirit of grace, spirit of supplication, spirit of prayer, spirit of intercession. Open your mouth and begin to pray tonight. Oh Lord, release it upon our life tonight. Release it upon our soul tonight. Open your mouth and begin to pray. All the prayerlessness, everything will vanish away. All the coldness, everything will disappear. Holy Ghost, take over once again in every heart. Even tonight, in the name of Jesus Christ. Oh Lord, we are asking for the spirit of grace. Oh Lord, we are asking for the spirit of prayer and supplication upon our life, oh God. Open heaven, my Father, once again and begin to release it upon our life tonight, oh God. Mighty God, in the name of Jesus Christ, conquer every dryness out of our life. Conquer every prayerlessness out of every life tonight, oh God. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, oh God, I'm asking my Father, power will come into us tonight. Anointing will flow into us tonight. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. In Jesus' name, we are praised.
Amen.
In Jesus' name, we pray.
Amen.
We want to tell the Lord tonight, brethren, we want to call upon the Lord. If we are going to really succeed in this God-given assignment, we need the power of the Holy Ghost. And that's exactly the promise of God for us. In Joel chapter 2, verse 28, and it shall come to pass in that day, in the last day, I will pour out my spirit upon all flesh. We want to cry to God and say, Lord, tonight, pour out your spirit upon our life. The spirit of power, the spirit of God, let it come upon us. In the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth, and the earth was without form and void, and darkness was upon the face of the deep. And the spirit of God, the spirit of God, the spirit of Jehovah, moved upon the face of the water. You want to pray tonight and say, God, let the Holy Ghost be released once again upon everyone connected on this platform. Open your mouth and begin to pray. Release your power. Release the Holy Ghost upon our soul, upon our spirit tonight. Open your mouth and begin to pray. Ignite the fire of the Spirit of God upon everyone to burn every chaff out of every life, every chaff of coldness, every chaff of weariness, every chaff of dryness in our soul, in our spirit. Open your mouth and begin to pray. And say, God, oh Lord, release your power, the power of the Holy Ghost to begin to work upon our life, to begin to strengthen us, to begin to energize us once again tonight. To begin to give us the vision. Open your mouth and call upon the Lord tonight. Holy Father, God, I'm asking once again tonight. Lord, I'm asking, open heaven, oh God. Release your power upon our life. The power of the Holy Ghost, the fire of the Holy Ghost, the anointing of the Holy Ghost, the freshness of the Holy Ghost in our spirits, in our soul, in our heart. Oh God, I'm asking my Father God that the Holy Ghost will take over my Father God. Even tonight, oh God, I'm asking my Father, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, Almighty God, visit everyone tonight. Visit every family connected, oh God. We are representing our family members. Begin to visit us tonight, oh God. Almighty God, I'm asking my Father God, even tonight in Jesus' name. Almighty God, I'm asking every imprisonment of the enemy in any life, in every heart, oh God, break in the name of Jesus Christ. In Jesus' name, we are praised.
Amen.
In Jesus' name we pray, brethren.
Amen.
We want to pray once again in Acts chapter 12, verse 5. The Bible says that Peter therefore was kept in prison. Do you know it's possible that even there are some people connected on this network, they have been caged, they have been incarcerated. Their spirit man is incarcerated. Their prayer life is incarcerated. In fact, it appears as if they are not even themselves again. We want to pray tonight. Bible says Peter, therefore, was kept in prison, but prayer was made without ceasing of the church for him. As a result of the prayer, Peter was released by God. God sent an angel of God to release Peter from that prison. We want to pray tonight as many who have been in prison. Spirit man, spirit, soul, and body, they have been in prison. We want to pray and say, God, pronounce liberty upon everyone tonight. We want to decree liberty. Total freedom for everyone. Open your mouth and begin to pray. And say, God, begin to liberate your people tonight by the finger of God, by the power of the Holy Ghost tonight. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, open your mouth and begin to call upon the Lord. And say, God, liberate your people, oh Lord. Liberate your people, those who have been incarcerated, those who have been bound at one point or the other. And it appears as if they are not even flowing. They are not even enjoying their spiritual life. They are not enjoying God's presence in their life. Oh Lord, liberate them by your mighty power tonight. Let tonight be a night of total liberty, a night of liberation, a night of total freedom in every heart, in every soul. Oh God, my Father, once again tonight, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, because it is written, if the Son therefore shall make us free, we shall be free indeed. Total freedom in every heart. Total freedom for everyone connected on this prayer network. Oh Lord, mighty God, I'm asking, begin to set the captive free. Even tonight, in Jesus' name, break all the shame, oh God. Break all the fetters tonight, oh God. By the power of the Holy Ghost, oh God, let every yoke be broken tonight. In every life tonight, oh God, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. In Jesus' name, we are praying.
Amen.
Amen. I return back again to that Ephesians chapter 3. Ephesians chapter 3. Please go along with me. Ephesians chapter 3. And I read that verse 17. It says that Christ may dwell in your heart, in our hearts, by faith. That Christ will dwell in our heart by faith. That ye being rooted and grounded in love. We want to pray tonight. Every one of us here tonight. Christ will dwell in our heart by faith. Christ will abide in our heart by faith. Christ will operate in our heart by faith. Oh, open your mouth and begin to pray and say, Lord Jesus Christ, begin to dwell in my heart once again. Operate through me. Operate in my heart even through me. Open your mouth and begin to pray tonight. And say, Lord Jesus Christ, oh Lord, dwell in my heart, reside in me, abide in me, be resident in me. Let your power, your grace be resident in my life. Open your mouth and begin to pray. When Christ abides inside you, every day you are going to experience the miracle of God. When Christ abides inside of you, every day you are going to see the touch of God. When Christ abides inside of you, you begin to see the invisible. Open your mouth and say, God, Christ, abide and dwell in my heart once again by faith. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, open your mouth and begin to pray. And say, Lord, I want to be rooted and be grounded in love. God is love. Open your mouth and begin to pray. Lord, make me to be rooted and to be grounded in love. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Open your mouth and begin to call upon the Lord tonight. Oh Lord, do it once again in my life, oh God, that Christ will dwell in our hearts, in the heart of our wives, our children, in the heart of every member of the church of the living God. Open your mouth and begin to pray tonight. Let Christ dwell in our heart and begin to control and begin to pray through us, even tonight in the name of Jesus Christ. Christ will dwell in us, in your spirit, in our lives. In Jesus' name, we are praying.
Amen.
Amen. We want to pray. We want to tell the Lord. In Revelation chapter 2, verse 4, Christ was talking to that church at Ephesus. He was talking to the angel of that church. He sent a message to that angel through Apostle Peter, Apostle John. And he said, nevertheless, I have somewhat against you, because thou hast left thy first love. I want to challenge you, brethren. You know how much you used to pray before. You know how much you loved the Lord before. You know how much you are consecrated before. You know how much you are dedicated unto God before. You know how much you studied the Bible before. How is it now? Is it like that? We want to pray. Oh God, let there be a restoration of that first love. First love into our heart. You know how much you used to evangelize. How you used to pray for sinners at that time. Do you still do that again? Why don't you open your mouth and say, God, let there be a restoration of the first love in our heart, in our soul, in our spirit. Open your mouth and begin to pray. In fact, by extension to all our churches, to all the members that we're leading, let's call upon the Lord and say, God, let there be a restoration of that first love once again in our heart, in the church of the living God, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. By this shall all men know that ye are my disciples. If you have love one towards another, open your mouth and let's call upon the Lord tonight. Oh God, the real love, the agape love, the first love, restore it back once again upon our hearts. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, open your mouth and call upon God tonight. Let's ask God and say, Lord, do it once again in our life. In the mighty name of Jesus, in Jesus' name, we are prayed.
Amen.
In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Amen. We want to pray in that verse 19. It said, and to know the love of Christ, which passes knowledge, that ye might be filled with all the fullness of God. Brothers and sisters, I do not know what you are actually aiming at. But let me say this. If you are filled with the fullness of God, do you know you have everything? You are filled with the fullness of God. Faith is there inside you. Strong faith, dynamic faith, working inside of you. Power of God is inside of you. Authority of a believer is inside of you. Glory, spirit of glory and of Christ, resting upon you. That you are filled with the fullness of God. You are going to pray and say, God, tonight, fill me with your fullness, O God. Fill me with your fullness, O God. I want to be filled with the fullness of God. Open your mouth, turn it to prayer, my brethren. Please don't close your mouth. A closed mouth is a closed destiny. A closed mouth is a closed destiny. Open your mouth and call upon God tonight and say, God, oh Lord, fill me once again with your fullness tonight. Fill me, oh God, afresh, oh God, with the fullness of God, the fullness of power, the fullness of anointing. How God anointed Jesus of Nazareth with the Holy Ghost and with power, who went about doing good and healing all that were oppressed of the devil. For God was within. Why don't you open your mouth and say, God of heaven, oh Lord, let that be. Fill me once again with your fullness tonight. Fill me with your fullness tonight, oh God. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, the power of God, the Holy Ghost power residing inside us, resurrection power residing in our lives, in our soul, in our spirit. Open your mouth and begin to pray and say, God, release your power upon our soul and upon our spirit. Fill me once again with your wisdom. Fill me with the fullness of your wisdom, fullness of your knowledge, fullness of your grace, fullness of your power, fullness of your authority, fullness of your anointing. Open your mouth and begin to pray tonight. Wherever you go, you carry power. Wherever you go, you carry anointing. Wherever you go, you carry authority. Open your mouth and begin to call upon the Lord tonight and say, God, fill me, oh God, with your fullness tonight, oh God, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Oh Lord, do it once again, oh God, in the mighty name of Jesus. Call upon the Lord, brethren. Open your mouth and pray. Open your mouth and call upon the Lord. Let's call upon the Lord. Let's talk to the Lord. Don't be weary, don't be tired. The Lord is your strength. Open your mouth and begin to pray. In the mighty name of Jesus, in Jesus' name, we have prayed.
Amen.
Amen. Brethren, we want to pray the second segment of this prayer. We want to pray for our nation, Nigeria. Our country, Nigeria. But before we do that, I want to read from Genesis chapter 11. Please, turn your Bible with me once again. Turn your Bible with me to Genesis chapter 11. Genesis chapter 11. Please, turn your Bible with me. We are praying for our nation, Nigeria. Already, God is doing wonders, and I'm going to share some testimony. I know you know it. I know you know some of those testimony. And God is actually answering the prayer of the saints, the prayer of the believers, the prayer of the committed and consecrated believers, those who are really looking up unto God, who are so concerned about the condition and the situation of this nation. Look at Genesis chapter 11. I want to read from verse 1. He said, and the whole earth was of one language. Take note. One language and of one speech. In verse 3, and they said one to another, go to, let us make brick and burn them thoroughly. And they had brick for stone and slime a day for mortar. And they said, go to, let us build a city and a tower whose top may reach unto heaven. And let us make us a name, lest we be scattered abroad upon the face of the whole earth. Look at verse 6. Let me read verse 5. And the Lord came down to see the city and the tower which the children of men built. And the Lord said, behold, the people is one, and they have all one language, and this they begin to do. And now nothing will be restrained from them which they have imagined to do. Verse 7. Go to, let us go down and there confound their language. That's where I'm going to. Let us go there and confound their language, that they may not understand one another's speech. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord. Now we are praying. We are praying for this. We want to pray for our nation, our country, Nigeria. You will understand what has been going on. And God is actually answering our prayers. Let me tell you something. It's a privilege that God has given to us to use us to pray for our nation, Nigeria. There are people from other churches. Let me tell you. A brother was sharing with me, not in our church, not in people life, from another ministry. They lost chosen precisely. And the man told me something. He said their GO declared, I think, more than 50 days of prayer and fasting. As I'm speaking to you now, they are still waiting upon the Lord because they just started not long. While some of us are dragging our feet, when we say let us pray for our nation at times, it looks as if we don't understand what is happening. We that we are here in Middlebelt and going to the northern part, we know what we are talking about. And that is why I want you to really take it with all seriousness. In a Redeemed Church, as I speak with you, Pastor Adeboye, by God's grace also, together with all the church members, they are praying. And apart from that, he has even set up a special prayer squad that are praying for Nigeria. And that is that's another church. And don't let us be left behind. And many of those ministries like that who are really serious minded, they know what it means that we have to pray for this country. We are going to pray. If you look at what has been happening, God is answering our prayers. Let me just share this testimony with us. Look at the terrorists that have been disturbing us in this place, in this northern part, northeast precisely. And that is the head of this Boko Haram. Now, when another group rose up just not too long, they call them ISWAP. And those people now, they have more sophisticated weapons than the BH, that is Boko Haram. And now, those people, they told those other people to submit, otherwise they will kill them, they will finish them. And they didn't want to agree. So fight broke out between the two of them. They began to fire artillery against each other. Some of their soldiers died. Some of the terrorists died on both parties. And the head of this Boko Haram felt that it's a shame for them to arrest him and to capture him, you know, single-handedly. That they will put him to shame. You know what he did? He blew up himself and he killed himself. That is exactly one of the prayers we have been praying. And beside that, that is that one aside. God is answering our prayers. You knew what actually happened on Friday. That's another one again. If you have been reading the news, you have been on the internet, you know that things have been happening. That some of these people traveling on by air and all that, I don't want to open my mouth to say because of the environment, they were, you know, roasted and virtually almost all of them, every one of them, they lost their life just like that. And is it not part of the answer that those that are troubling us, those who are causing conflict, commotion, problems here and there, if they refuse to repent, God should take them out of the way. And God is actually doing it. And we're still going to pray. As I speak with you now, there is a conflict going on, a misunderstanding right now going on between Kaduna State Governor and even Kano State Governor. They are not in good terms as I'm talking to you now. And that is one of our prayer requests, let me tell you. So I'm only trying to open your eyes to some of those things happening. And the reason why we need to pray more, we must not relax at this time. We want to pray, number one, that those who are ganging up and those conspirators who are conspiring to actually, you know, they want to knock out the church from the land. They want to establish what I can call Fulanization of this nation and even Islamization and all that. We want to pray tonight. The Lord will scatter them. The Lord will confound them. All Amen. The agreement between them, they will be scattered. Let's open our mouth and begin to pray. Open your mouth and begin to pray. And the Lord will lead you. Please pray that prayer with all your hearts. pray with all sincerity of heart and mind, because many things are actually happening. We need to cry to God and say, God, Lord, all the conspirators, all the enemies of this nation that are planning in one place and they are gathering together, what is the main line of action? Anyway, they are at this time, the Lord will set confusion in their midst. Let God begin to confuse their language. Let God begin to confuse their speech. Let God begin to confound them. Open your mouth and begin to pray. They will not be able to understand one another any longer. Open your mouth and begin to call upon the Lord. Let God arise on our behalf, particularly on behalf of the elect in this nation, on behalf of the children of God in this nation. Let God arise and begin to fight the battle for us and give us the total victory and silence every opposition of the enemy. Every opposition coming from the enemy camp, oh Lord, arise tonight and begin to silence them in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Oh God, everlasting Father, I'm asking, oh Lord, that to arise in the greatness of your power, this children of the born woman that have been planning, have been conspiring together, and they said so. They want to establish the foundation and the truth in this country, oh Lord. Begin to stop them, begin to confuse them, oh God. Confuse their language, confuse their speeches, oh God. They will not be able to understand one another any longer. Almighty God, let your power prevail upon every one of them, oh God, Almighty God, I'm asking my Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, oh Lord, arise on our behalf. Oh Lord, the battle belongs to you, my Father God, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. In Jesus' name, we are praying. Amen. We are going to pray, my brethren. We are going to call upon the Lord. The Bible says, upon this rock I build my church. Upon this rock I build my church. And the gate of hell, the gate of darkness, the gate of all those false religions, the gate of all those satanic kingdoms, the gate of all those satanic altars, they will not prevail against the church. We are going to pray. Every gate of hell fighting against the church in Nigeria, let them begin to collapse in the name of Jesus Christ. Open your mouth and begin to pray right now. All the gates of hell fighting against Christianity in the north, in the south, in the east, in the west, all over, everywhere. Oh God, arise tonight, begin to collapse all those gates of hell against your church. Let them begin to crumble tonight. Let them begin to collapse in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Open your mouth and begin to pray. Pray with all fervency of our brethren. Pray with all your heart. Pray with earnestness. The effectual fervent prayer of a righteous man, of a righteous woman, availeth much. Open your mouth and begin to call upon God. Say, God, oh Lord, arise and give us the victory tonight. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Almighty God, oh Lord, every gate of hell fighting against the church, fighting against Christianity, fighting against the people of God, fighting against children of promise, Almighty God, arise tonight, oh God. Let those gates of hell begin to crash, let them begin to crash land. Let them begin to crash land tonight in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Oh Lord, arise tonight, oh God, all the conspiracy going on against Christianity, all the conspiracy going on against the King of God. Oh Lord, I'm asking tonight, let those conspiracy begin to receive the thunder and the fire of God tonight in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Oh Lord, give us the victory. Oh Lord, arise tonight, oh God. Let your kingdom be established here on earth, oh God, in the mighty name of Jesus. In Jesus' name, we are praying. Amen. We're going to pray, brethren. We're going to tell the Lord that every satanic agenda against Christianity, against the Church of Christ in Nigeria, that God Almighty will arise tonight. He will scatter them. He will disconfit them even tonight. All those satanic agenda, either to take over the nation, and then they want to fill it with their own religion, all the empty false religion. We want to pray and say, God, all those satanic agenda tonight, let the fire of God begin to consume them. Open your mouth and begin to pray. Open your mouth and begin to pray, my brethren. Open your mouth and call upon the Lord. every satanic agenda against the Church of Christ in this country, in this nation, oh Lord, scatter and demolish everything tonight. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, let the Holy Ghost, like a bulldozer, begin to bulldoze everything out. Holy Ghost, like a bulldozer, begin to bulldoze everything away and begin to scatter all the plan in the name of Jesus Christ. In the mighty name of Jesus, oh Lord, everlasting Father God, reign, oh God. In Jesus' name, we are praying. Amen. We want to make a decree. The Bible says, thou shalt decree a thing and it shall be established unto you, unto me. We are going to make a decree tonight. When there was a storm, Jesus Christ told him, he said, let us cross over. And while they were crossing over, there was a mighty storm. You know, if you look at what is happening right now in Nigeria, in south-south, in south-east, in south-west, the storm is almost raging. Storms of war, storms of killing, storms of terrorism, storms of banditry, storms of this and that. We want to pray. Let there be calm. Be still right now. We want to make a decree. You stormy wind, be still. In the name of Jesus Christ, open your mouth and begin to pray. Even to the northeast, to the northwest, to the north central, open your mouth and ask God and say, Lord, we command the peace of God to reign. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, every stormy wind, all the wind that is raging everywhere, causing commotion, causing confusion, causing pandemonium, causing catastrophe, causing a lot of things happening here and there, people having their people getting lost. And we want to pray and say, God, let the storm begin to cease now. In the mighty name of Jesus, you stormy wind be still. You stormy wind be still. In the authority of the name of Jesus, be still now. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, be still now. In the name of Jesus, oh Lord, take over the affairs of this nation. In the mighty name of Jesus, in Jesus' name, we are praying. Amen. It is done.
Amen.
I said it is done.
Amen.
Please, is Pastor Peter online?
Amen.
Is Pastor Peter online?
Yes, sir.
Please help us round up, sir.
In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Our Father, Amen. Our God, we want to bless and worship your name for your goodness. Thank you for the great things you are doing in the world today. We exalt your name for your grace that is still keeping your people. We adore you for everything. The glory, honor, adoration, and thanksgiving be unto your name, O Lord, in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Father, we thank you for holding your word. For as heaven and earth will pass away, but your word will not pass. Even a teeth will not pass. All is fulfilled. You have said, no matter what happens, you will keep your church. We exalt your name for keeping your church. We thank you for your hand upon your people. We thank you for your grace upon us. We say, glory, honor, adoration, and thanksgiving be unto your name, O Lord, in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Lord, for you, we thank you for all that our brother, our pastor, has led us through. We exalt your name because you are the God that answered prayer. The God that everything we have requested with thanksgiving will come speedily to us, O Lord, in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Father, we remember some of our people that might be passing through persecution because of what is happening right now, especially in our nation, Nigeria, here. Oh Lord, we pray that your hand will continue to rest upon them. Your spirit will continue to abide with them. You continue to give them within to push on to see you face to face in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Lord, we commit those that are behind all these issues into your hands. You have said it to your word, do and join to hand. The wicked shall not go unpunished. Oh Lord, but we are praying, that these people, your mighty power, will rise up against them. They will bring great confusion among them. They don't understand themselves to do any more harm to your people, Lord, in Jesus' name.
Amen.
And Lord Jesus, we are praying that you will touch the heart of these people. Convert some of them. Touch them. Bring them on their knees like you did to Saul on the way to Damascus. Oh Lord God, now we pray that you arrest some of them so that your name will be glorified in our nation and worldwide in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord, for having answered prayers, O Lord. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
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 Okay, Pastor Matthew, you can take over, sir.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
We want to praise the name of the Lord because of our leader for the prayer he has listed. And then the Bible says in the book of Psalms, chapter 68, verse 4. I will read to 5. Chapter 68, I will read 4 to 5. It says, sing unto God. For most of all that we are in Zoom, please do not forget that another church will cease by 5 o'clock. So please, in case they cease, use go to YouTube or you use the freeconferencecall.com. We should go to YouTube or we use freeconference.com. One of our church that are just getting up, they will use it soon. So please. So the Bible said, sing unto God, sing praises to his name, and so him that rideth upon the heaven by his name, and rejoice before him. A father of the fatherless. Look at what we are saying. Yes, some of these tribes, they believe they are the one that own the nation. They believe the political part of the nation is their father right, and that nobody can able to claim it with them. But the Bible is telling us that God is a father of the fatherless. Even if they think the other side has no right, the other side has no jurisdiction to able to get to that post, to able to control that, they just want to fulfill the promise of the Lord. Because God will prove himself that he is the father of those people who think other people does not have the right to those and the judge of the widows. Is God is only a habitat, but this is area where we are going. In order for you to be beneficiary of this situation, our pastor has shown us what is happening, that the God is answering prayer. But I want to tell you, this happened in the Christendom. Many of us, we hear the promises, we don't see it. Many of us, they tell us the promises, we don't witness it. It's got better. It's what many people will be until the kingdom come. But the Bible was telling me here today that God is his only inhabitant. And those people who are holy, they will inhabit that promise with him. You will not call upon the name of the Lord. Father, whatsoever that can disqualify me from being holy to able to inhabit your place with you, to able to inhabit your promise with you. Father, I don't want to hear the promise of Nigeria is going to better. I want to be the partaker of God is better. That by the power in the blood of Jesus Christ, all our holiness in my life, Father, take away in Jesus' name. Call upon the name of the Lord, call upon the name of the Lord. Open your mouth, call upon the name of the Lord. Since I was born, they have been saying is, Nigeria is going to be better. My dear brother, my dear sister in the Lord, out of that Nigeria is going to be better with the people who have been in houses. Out of that Nigeria is going to be better with the people who are having good care. Out of that Nigeria is going to be better with the people who are sending their children to abroad to go and read. Out of that Nigeria is going to be better with the people who are on top. My dear brother, many people have been there like that. That's the year the promise, but they will not be witnesses. Call upon the name of the Lord. Call upon the name of the Lord. The Almighty Father, I want to be the inheritance of this promise. Almighty Father, whatsoever, they will not let me be able to be the beneficiary of this promise. Father, take it away from my life in the name of Jesus Christ. Whatsoever it may be, just a little thing in the corridor of my room, just a little thing in my place of work, just a little thing before me and my husband, just a little thing before me and my wife, just a little thing before me and my colleague, just a little thing before me in the ministry, just a little thing before me in the baby in my steward. Just a little bit before me in this straightforward unto you. But Almighty Father, there's a way of compromise, and there's a result of this. I've seen people who have been in the inheritance of these promises, but I have not. Call upon the name of the Lord, including me, including my children. Including me, including my family. Including me, including myself. Call upon the name of the Lord. Whatsoever, in the kingdom of God, the mighty God in battle, that will not let me be in that will not let me inherit the promise of the Lord. That Nigeria is good. That Nigeria is going to good. That Nigeria is going to better. That Nigeria is becoming a good nation. Oh, mighty Father, whatsoever, don't take a vertical relationship. By the power and the blood of Jesus Christ. Father, take it away from my life in the name of Jesus Christ. Oh, mighty God. The Bible lets me know. Everyone and earth belong to God. Where you have been walking, like an elephant, that I will be eating, like a rat. Let them open for me in the name of Jesus Christ. Let them open for me in the name of Jesus Christ. Father, King of Kings, Lord of Lords, in my language, one is a lemon to sue me. He is a lemon to sue me. Call upon the name of the Lord. I said, I'll be an agent of receiver only. I want to be a giver. I want to be a distributor of your blessing.
Let me see you. Let the flow for me
beneficiary of this Nigeria is good. Don't you hear me? In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Pastor, say grand for us.
In Jesus' name we are prayed.
Amen.
Father, we give you all the glory. We appreciate you, God, for all that you have done for us. Thank you for your leading. Thank you for the way you have directed the affairs of this prayer tonight.
Thank you,
Lord, we bless you because we have already seen the effect of our prayers. We already see the answer being granted on every side. Lord, we are praying, oh God, much more than what you have seen. You will surprise us, particularly concerning the case of this nation, Nigeria, oh Lord. Attend to all our needs, oh God, in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Father, we pray once again for all the brethren, all our pastors, and all the brothers, all the sisters connected on this prayer platform. We pray, Lord, you know all our needs, O God. You know what you have been asking from you. You know all our heart desire. And you say one thing over you desire. When ye pray, believe that you receive them, and ye shall have them. Father, we are praying, O God, attend to every one of our needs, O God. Even from this very moment, O God, in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Lord, all the things that we have been asking from you, those who are asking for a breakthrough in the area of marriage, those who are asking from you for the fruit of the womb, those who are asking for provision, those who are asking for financial supply to be able to meet one need or the other, those who are asking and say, God, I want to climb higher. Oh Lord, I pray that God, you will give every one of us a better life. Better, better, better promising life in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Father, we pray, God, as you are moving, as you have entered this new week, Lord, we prophesy. I will make a declaration tonight. Goodness and mercy will follow us.
Amen.
Sorrow and sadness will not follow us.
Amen.
Affliction and untimely death will not follow any one of us in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Father, we appreciate you once again for your servant, our pastor, that you have been using to sponsor this program. We pray, Lord, the Bible said, the liberal shall be made fast, and he that watereth shall be watered also. I pray, God, you continue to add value to his life in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Thank you, everlasting Father.
Thank you, Lord.
In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed.
Amen. Thank you. Let's share the grace together. We shall meet in mass prayer by the grace of the Lord. Let's share the grace together.
The grace of the Lord, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit.
Be with us now and forevermore.
Amen.
Surely,
goodness and mercy shall follow us all the days of our lives,
and we shall dwell in the house of
the Lord forever and ever.
Amen. Thank you. God bless you all. We shall meet in men's prayer meeting. Thank you.